Here's Anthony Blinken, U.S. Secretary of State, yesterday talked about Tigray conflict. He mentioned four important points. Firstly, he said that the U.S. wanted to enter Tigray. Does it mean that the U.S. is going for military intervention in Tigray? No, viewers. Anthony Blinken is saying that the U.S. Humanitarian organizations will enter Tigray. Some U.S. Aid organizations are already working in Tigray, viewers. USAID is working in collaboration with UNICEF and Red Cross. Then CRS, Catholic Relief Services, which is a US-based aid organization, it is also working in Tigray. So the purpose of these US aid organizations is to give humanitarian assistance and to inform the US government about on-ground situation in Tigray. Secondly, viewers, he was asked a question about the deployment of UN peacekeepers in Tigray. He said that the first priority for the US in Tigray was to ensure withdrawal of Eritrean and Amhara forces from Tigray. So, in a way, he did not answer the question regarding the deployment of UN peacekeepers in Tigray. Thirdly, viewers, he talked about ethnic cleansing in Tigray. He said that there was reports about ethnic cleansing in western Tigray, and Tigrayans were being forcibly pushed out of western Tigray. This report about ethnic cleansing in western Tigray has been confirmed by some aid organizations, viewers. Reportedly, more than 10,000 Tigrayans have entered Shere from western Tigray, from Homera, from Volkait. And that is why, according to some sources, Tigrayans in western Tigray region are being pushed towards a central Tigray region. Lastly, viewers, he talked about the Tigray conflict as a whole. He said that situation in Tigray was unacceptable. It must change.
That meets their interests and avoids conflict. And I think we can use our good offices to help do that. So that's the way we're approaching it. The challenge in Ethiopia is very significant, and it's one that we're very very focused on, particularly the situation in Tigray, where we are seeing very credible reports of human rights abuses and atrocities that are ongoing. And I've been on the phone on several occasions now with Prime Minister Abiy of Ethiopia. I've talked to other leaders in the region and on the continent and beyond. I very much understand the concerns, for example, that the Prime Minister had about the TPLF and its actions, but the situation in Tigray today is unacceptable and has to change. And that means a few things. It means making sure that we're getting into the region, into Tigray, aid workers and others, humanitarian assistance, to make sure that the people are cared for, provided for, and protected. And it's very important that the government follow through on commitments that it's made.
Do you envision peacekeepers?
At this point, we have two other challenges that go to the security piece. One is we have, as you know, forces from Eritrea that are there, and we have forces from an adjoining region, Amhara, that are there. They need to come out, and a force that will not abuse the human rights of the people of Tigray or commit acts of ethnic cleansing, which we've seen in western Tigray, that has to stop. We also need full accountability. We need to get an independent investigation into what took place there. And we need some kind of process, a reconciliation process, so that the country can move forward.